If you have ever thought in the past about stem length on your road bike, it is probably because you've been thinking about comfort and fit on your bike. However, with mountain bikers, when they think about the length of their stems, they are thinking more about the handling of the bike and the way it feels when they steer.
Yeah, so could we change the way that our road bikes feel by messing around with stem length? Could we make them more nimble, more agile, faster even?
We've been thinking about this subject because of the current trend amongst professional cyclists who are trying to get longer and lower at the front end in order to become more aerodynamic. The problem with that is that they are choosing frames which are one size smaller than they really should be riding, and therefore the reach is too short. And to compensate for this, they are using some humongous stems, sometimes up to 14 or even 15 centimetres long.
15 centimetres, that's like 6 inches down. That is huge. Surely that is going to make things a little bit difficult in the steering department. Surely they'd be better off with an 11 centimetre stem, a bit more standard. But then even, wouldn't things not be better with an 8? Should we find out?
Let's do it.
We've got a selection of the new Pro Vibe aerodynamic stems to try out on Dan's bike. First of all, we've got this little stubby 8 centimetre number. We've got an 11 centimetre one already on the bike. And then finally, we've got this humongous 14 centimetre stem.
That looks longer than 14 centimetres. That's 6 inches.
It does look big, doesn't it? It depends where you measure from. So you always go from centre to centre, of course, when you're measuring the stem.
Slight illusion there. Yeah. What we are going to do is a little course which we set here in suburbia, a little bit like a kids' day skills course. What we're going to do is weave in and out of these cones around the roundabout just behind you and back again. Firstly, and mainly to see how it feels with the different stem lengths, but we are also going to time it just to see if there's any statistical difference.
And also to find out who's king of the car park skills. Neil Dan.
Bring it on. Three, two, one, go. Oh no, he's 11.98, but with a 10 second penalty.
10 second penalty? No, I'm not having that. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh. No, I think you fluffed it.
Have I?
11.77.
3, 2, 1, go.
Oh, he's looking fast. Looking really fast. 11.17. It's a PB for Lloyd.
Oh, it is it?
Yeah. 3, 2, 1, go.
Six.
Come on, Lloydie.
12.14.
Whoa. The reason that we think there might be a difference is that stem length affects the steering arc. The shorter the stem, the less you will need to move your hands in order to turn the wheel a set amount. That's one reason why mountain bikers prefer short stems, better for weaving around trees. Now, stem length isn't the only thing governing handling. The head angle and the trail of the bike give built-in handling traits, like the DNA of a bike. But changing stems can have a huge difference. What happens then on the slow speed test?
The results are in, Si, and what I can tell you is that basically we got better as we went on with practice. We were both quickest on the 8 centimetre at the end. And I also have to tell you, unfortunately, you were better on every single run, and I'm devastated.
I don't feel so bad about the rubbish results then. Okay, given that practice clearly makes perfect, can we infer anything from the feel? Did it feel different?
Well, I was expecting a much bigger difference in feel between the stems, because there's quite a big difference between 14 and 8, but actually, what I felt was that I was just most comfortable on the 14 centimetre, because that's closest to my normal riding position.
Yeah, well, I definitely felt that the 8 centimetre was easier to weave through the cones, but then weirdly, it's actually harder to get round the bottom corner. So I feel that maybe we need to move from this kind of artificial challenge to a real world challenge? Because how many Tour de France stages will have riders weaving through cones and then chucking a U-turn in a row?
That is true. There's the occasional dog runs out into the peloton, isn't there? And sometimes you have to weave around a couple of spectators to get to the sign on. But I take your point. Descending challenge, do you think?
Descending challenge.
Real world.
You know, it does feel twitchy. My God.
Ah! It's responsive. Maybe a bit too responsive. I'm not sure I like that. And go.
That feels better. Heaps better. Wow, that made a heck of a difference. Just a totally different animal down there. That's the kind of bike that I know and love. Size matters, clearly, when you're going fast. Those of you that are familiar with the new Pro Vibe handlebar system will know that we're not exactly getting the most out of its aerodynamic properties. And that's because we're still running this external DI2 junction box, whereas we should really be using a hidden junction box in the end of the handlebar there, because all the cables can route internally through the bars and out of this point here, into the stem, and then out of the stem, through that hole at the back, and then actually down into the steerer tube, completely hidden away. 3, 2, 1, go. Wow, rolling out the big guns. Woo-hoo-hoo. Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what, the difference between this and the 11 is nowhere near as big as the 11 and the 8. But it does feel, really stable, and particularly interesting, it feels really good around corners. Like that bike just wants to rail. That has surprised me a lot. Dan, I've got some results.
Go on in.
Entirely traffic dependent.
Yeah, I thought so. My last run was easily the fastest because I wasn't held up by multiple cars and a tractor.
Well, you'll also be pleased to know that you have the fastest of the day.
Oh, yes.
So I may be car park king, but you are downhill demon. So
that is good to hear. In terms of how it felt down the descent, though, I was really at home on this one. I realised when I was going down the hill that you don't turn the bars much at all. You're literally banking through the corners. Having that long stem where it's slightly harder to turn the bars actually made me feel a lot more stable. I was carving and flowing through those corners.
Carving and flowing?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, in contrast, the 80mm stem was utterly terrifying.
Yeah.
From the moment I set off and got above 20 miles an hour, it felt way, way too twitchy and really not good through corners at all. And then I suppose the 110 was kind of the Goldilocks, really. It didn't feel quite as stable, but then it just felt right.
Yeah, I was happy enough on the 110. I think one thing we should mention, though, is that in our pro days, did we mention that? We were trying to get long and low and aerodynamic, and so quite often we favoured the long stem. So that is something we've been used to for many, many years, isn't it?
Well, it is, but I have, since retiring and getting older, gone shorter. So I now use a 110mm stem. But it did feel good, nevertheless, going back onto a longer stem. Should you go and buy a longer stem then to mimic these results? I don't think you should, given that actually bike fit should probably be the determining factor. But don't be put off by experimenting with a longer stem, I think. Bikes feel good.
Now, before we conducted our very own stem length experiment, we did consult with bike design guru Tom Sturdy, who typically has already done quite a lot of experimenting himself. And what he has found is that you're probably not going to be able to find much of a difference between a long bike with a short stem versus a shorter bike with a long stem. But he does say that that choice is very important for shorter riders due to the limit of wheel sizes. If you are a shorter rider, you really want to go for a longer frame with a shorter stem.
Yeah, and then in order to offset that twitchiness that we've just been experiencing, you'd then hope that the actual geometry of the bike, as we talked about, the DNA of it, would actually mean that it had more inbuilt stability. But then, thinking about that point, actually, although stem length doesn't have much of an effect on the way it rides, actually, in order to feel the bike as it was designed to be felt, you should probably use it with the stem length that it was spec'd with, I guess, as the designer intended.
Yeah, it does start to get a bit complicated, doesn't it? But you can rest assured that there is a good reason why bike geometry has remained pretty much the same for decades.
Yeah. Right then, I guess all we can ask now at this point is for you to subscribe to GCN. To do that, just click on the globe. And if you'd like to watch a couple more videos, Matt did a great video where he asked the pros why they slam their stems. That's just down there.
Yeah, or a few years ago, Si had a look into how you should set your bike and stem up, and you can find that video just down here.
A few years ago, it was pretty, it goes back a bit now.
Yeah, you looked really young.